us. And we're going out there and we're going to do our work. And we're not going to commit any shirk. We're not going to commit any kufr. We're going to be all right. Whatever mistakes we make, we will simply reverse them and keep on getting up and keep on moving. That's what it means to have empowered Muslims. Muslims who can deploy their talents to the nth degree. We don't need Muslims who are scared of their shadows. We don't need Muslims who have to come into their own communities and perform. We need Muslims who are comfortable in their own skin, who are confident, who are empowered, who believe in their Lord, and know, they can't hide anything from God. So ain't no use in trying to hide anything from the people. This is what we have to get back to. Empowering Muslims through Islam. These are some of the problems that worry me when I begin to think about the transgenerational transference, continuity of Islam. And these are problems that we Muslims, we have to be the ones to address them. Now, I mentioned that we got some help in some of this alienation. And I have very little time, so I want to try and squeeze this in. And this goes back to the point that I've been making all the time. We need everybody. We need everybody. Because here's the challenge that we have right now. So many Muslims are afraid of their religion. Not simply because of some of the mistakes that we have made. Not simply because of some of the ways that the religious tradition has been deployed by certain individuals. But because our entire being has now been calibrated on the basis of someone else's values, someone else's sensibilities, and someone else's vision. And now we got a whole prism that's been dictated by them, with which we are now trying to read our own religion. We're reading our own religion through somebody else's eyes, somebody else's fears, somebody else's sensibilities. You cannot give them monopoly over the definition of tolerance, monopoly over the definition of reason, monopoly over the definition of democracy, monopoly over the definition of everything that regulates everyday life, and then expect not to see your religion the way they see it. And what are we going to do about this? We have to take our own definitions back. We have to say, we have an Islamic concept of freedom. We have an Islamic concept of reason. We have an Islamic concept of tolerance. And we have to be the people who put this forth and defend it. And this has to be the instrumentalities that calculate, that calibrate the Muslim self. If someone else is calibrating them, they're going to be calibrated to see the world, including Islam, as that symbol of disease. And as long as that's the case,
I'm gonna see you tomorrow then? Inshallah. I know.
That's good stuff.